how you move toward the door. Here it comes, the hardest part. Try to hand the love alone. Feeling different, feeling strange. This can never be arranged. As the light fades from the screen, from the famous final scene,
hello, let's start with a little dance.
If I had words to make a day for you, I'd sing you a morning golden and true. I would make this day last for all time, then fill the night deep in moonshine. If I had words to make a day for you, I'd give you a morning golden and true. I would make this day last for all time.
Nothing tricksy, just a bloke dancing for a pig. As happy and as uplifting a scene as you'll ever see. And have you noticed, although Babe had plenty of special effects, they weren't the scenes that were chosen. In fact, there's not one clip in the top 60 that has special effects, other than 2001 and Close Encounters. I haven't featured them because, frankly, they look so dated. Several people voted for the whole of The Matrix, which wasn't very helpful, but also allowed me not to show any of it. I'll be so glad when teams stop coming to me with Like the Matrix as an idea. So, this week, let's look at ideas. Two lads visiting their gay mad uncle is an idea, providing you have a deft hand with dialogue and three professional actors. People in a house following the rhythm of a bonking couple, or an explorer being challenged to a duel by a giant with a sword are ideas. The result of cowboys eating beans is an idea which could only occur to a sick mind, but none of them need special effects.
Well, hello! Come in.
Sit down, do. Would you like a drink?
Sherry.
Sherry. Sherry?
Sherry.
Sherry. Do you like vegetables? I've always been fond of root crops, but I only started to grow last summer. I happen to think the cauliflower more beautiful than the rose.
Chin chin.
Do you grow
geraniums?
Oh, you little traitors. I think the carrot infinitely more fascinating than the geranium. The carrot has mystery. Flowers are essentially tarts. Prostitutes for the bees. There is, you will agree, certain je ne sais quoi, something very special about a firm young carrot. Excuse me. Do help yourself another drink.
Consolist, the man's mad, eccentric. Eccentric, he's insane. Not only that, he's a raving homosexual.
You beastly little parasite, how dare you? You little thug, how dare you? Beastly, ungrateful little swine.
I'd say you've had enough.
Let's look at three scenes that contain lines which have gone into the lexicon. No special effects needed.
Your friend in there will be looking for you. Incidentally, you never told me. Are you married?
Am I not a man? And is not a man stupid? I'm a man. So, I'm married. Wife, children, house, everything. The full catastrophe.
This is gold, Mr. Bond. All my life, I've been in love with its color, its brilliance, its divine heaviness. I welcome any enterprise that will increase my stock, which is considerable.
I think you've made your point, Goldfinger. Thank you for the demonstration.
Choose your next witticism carefully, Mr. Bond. It may be your last. The purpose of our two previous encounters is now very clear to me. I do not intend to be distracted by another. Good night, Mr. Bond.
Do you expect me to talk?
No, Mr. Bond, I expect you to die.
Five, four, three, two, one, go. You're only supposed to blow the bloody doors off!
In this Jubilee year, let's look at a couple of simple bits of film involving Queens walking.
Let's try walking.
Holding the sandwich?
Doesn't matter. Just walk. Down.
Too swishy?
Let me give you an image. It's a cliche, but it's an image. John Wayne.
Oh, God. Couldn't we start with someone easier?
Come on, you're a big fan. He's got a very distinctive walk. Very easy to imitate. And if anyone was a man... All right, now try it. Just get off your horse and head into the saloon. Nice touch.
Howdy, man. No good?
Actually, it's perfect. I just never realized John Wayne walked like that.
Let's look at one great scene with a big idea, no great dialogue, and huge emotion. Another, a classic, in which the dialogue is so great that we almost ignore the fact that the car is stationary. Or maybe the streets in New York were better paved back then.
I said leave, Mr. Keating.
Captain, my captain.
Sit down, Mr. Anderson. You hear me? Sit down. Sit down.
This is your final warning, Anderson. How dare you? Do you hear me?
No, Captain, my captain.
Mr. Overstreet, I warn you. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. All of you. I want you seated. Sit down. Leave, Mr. Keating.
Skunk, we got you for a manager. He brought you along too fast.
It wasn't him, Charlie. It was you. You remember that night in the garden? You came down my dressing room and said, kid, this ain't your night. We're going for a price on Wilson. You remember that? This ain't your night. My night? I could have taken Wilson apart. So what happens? He gets the title shot outdoors in a ballpark, and what do I get? A one-way ticket to Palookaville. You was my brother, Charlie. You should have looked out for me a little bit. You should have taken care of me just a little bit so I wouldn't have to take them dives for the short-end money.
Well, I had some bets down for you. You saw some money.
You don't understand. I could have had class. I could have been a contender. I could have been somebody instead of a bum, which is what I am. Let's face it. Was you, Charlie.
Now, here are two clips from the same movie. Again, a classic. One, a classic lesson in camera work, direction, and performance. And the second, a classic lesson in dialogue writing and delivery. If there's a single person with whom I'd swap lives, it'd be Orson Welles.
Thank you. kind of a spy do you think you are, Satchel Foot? What are you tailing me for? Cat got your tongue? Come on out. Come out, come out, whoever you are. Step out in the light and let's have a look at you. Who's your boss?
You're too bad, no one was sitting down loose.
Sonst was wollte nun überhaupt sein? Seien Sie deppert? Ja, Sie meine ich, schauen Sie zu blöd. Eine Frechheit ist das, mitten in der Nacht zu einem Krawall zu kommen.
Harry!
Eine Frechheit ist das, zu einem Krawall zu kommen.
The fella said, mentally, for 30 years under the Borgias, they had warfare, terror, murder, and bloodshed, but they produced Michelangelo, Leonardo da Vinci, and the Renaissance. In Switzerland, they had brotherly love. They had 500 years of democracy and peace, and what did that produce? The cuckoo clock. So long, Holly.
Great line. And for 5 points, who played the zither in The Third Man? And almost finally, a look at violence. We haven't seen much of that, and in truth, very few violent scenes were voted for. But here are three that were. The first is horrifying in its matter-of-factness. Unlike the baroque weirdness of the ear scene in Reservoir Dogs, it's just men going to work. On other men. The second is probably the most terrifying bit of performance ever by a British actor. When I first saw this on DVD in my home, I shoved the chair away from the screen when this bit came on. I've known people like that, and I hope never to meet any more. Ben Kingsley deserved an Oscar, and I assume he missed out because the rest of the film was crap. Of course, you may find some of the dialogue a bit monotonous. And the third is the seventh highest voted for clip on the list, and should have been higher. Two great actors, a situation in which one is going to torture the other to death, and some of the most inspired dialogue ever written. Nice track, too.
Frankie, leave the kid alone. He's still breathing.
Still breathing. Leave him alone.
Frankie!
Hi. Strip him.
No ball. No fucking ball.
The word was out.
The bosses had enough of Nicky. They had enough. How much were they going to take? So they made an example of him and his brother. They buried him while he was still breathing.
What happened, Doc?
What happened? What fucking happened? I'll tell you what fucking happened. You tell me, Gal. You tell me what fucking happened. Give me a fucking knockback, you fat fucking cunt.
Problem with the plane, Doc?
What's that? What did you fucking say, cunt? What? Problem? Fucking problem? No, mate, no. No fucking problem with the plane, cunt. Fucking plane was fine. Fucking plane was all right. Fucking plane was perfect. It's you. You're the problem. You're the fucking problem. You fucking Dr. White, honking jam rag, arcing spunk bubble. I'm telling you, H, you keep looking at me, I'm going to put you in the fucking ground. I promise you.
You're Sicilian, huh?
Sicilian.
You know, I read a lot, especially about things, about history. I find that shit fascinating. Here's a fact. I don't know whether you know or not. Well, Sicilians were spawned by niggers.
Come again?
it's a fact. Yeah. You see, Sicilians have black blood pumping through their hearts. And no, if you don't believe me, you can look it up. Hundreds and hundreds of years ago, the Moors conquered Sicily. And the Moors are niggers. Yes. See, way back then, Sicilians were like wops from northern Italy. They all had blonde hair and blue eyes. But, then the Moors moved in there and, they changed the whole country. They did so much fucking with Sicilian women, huh? That they changed the whole bloodline forever. That's why blonde hair and blue eyes became black hair and dark skin. You know, it's absolutely amazing to me to think that to this day, hundreds of years later, that Sicilians still carry that nigger gene. Now this, I'm quoting history. It's written. It's a fact. It's written.
I know this guy.
Your ancestors are niggers. And your great, 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 great grandmother fucked a nigger.
Oh, yeah.
And she had a half nigger kid. Now, if that's a fact, tell me, am I lying? Because you're part eggplant.
Hey. You're a cantaloupe.
And the final clip. This got more votes than any other by quite a large margin. Now, while it wouldn't be number one on my list, I totally understand why it won. It has tension, humor, dialogue that's memorable and real, without pretension, and two great actors at their peak.
Kid, the next time I say let's go someplace like Bolivia, let's go someplace like Bolivia.
Next time. Ready?
No, we'll jump.
Like hell we will.
No, it'll be okay. If the water's deep enough, we don't get squished to death. They'll never follow us.
How do you know?
Would you make a jump like that you didn't have to?
I have to, and I'm not gonna.
Well, we got to, otherwise we're dead. They're just gonna have to go back down the same way they come. Come on.
Just one clear shot, that's all I want.
Come on. We got to.
Nope. Get away from me.
Why?
I want to fight them.
They'll kill us.
Maybe.
You want to die?
Do you?
All right. I'll jump first.
Nope.
Then you jump first.
No, I said.
What's the matter with you?
I can't swim.
Why, are you crazy? The fall will probably kill you.
Oh, shit! That's it then. 2 hours and about 70 of the top 100 clips voted for. The rest only got one or two votes, or I hated them, That's my tape, so there. The little brochure that goes with this will show you how I split the clips into genres and how each of them measures on the 6-criteria scale. All that may or may not be interesting to you. What I hope you'll take from this is the fact that memorable moments on film are rarely huge in terms of production. The most important factor is some sort of shock. Irreverence, contradiction, oddness, that sets the situation aside from the norm. And the second is dialogue. In advertising, just as we're losing the ability to write long copy, we're losing, if we ever had it, the ability to write great dialogue. And if we can't do that, we're cheating our clients. Because journalists and filmmakers, the people whose work people pay to see, are still doing it, and winning hearts and minds. Finally, music. If you can't write dialogue, don't try. Just get a great soundtrack on there, and maybe nobody will notice that you're an illiterate poltroon. To close, here's a remarkable scene from a rather unremarkable film. The change of pace and mood are so brilliantly handled that even the on-screen presence of Michael York can't ruin it. Thanks for watching. Bye now.
The sun on the meadow is summery warm. The stag in the forest runs free. But gather together to greet the storm. Tomorrow belongs to me. The branch of the linden is leafy and green. The Rhine gives its gold to the sea. But somewhere a glory of it unseen. Tomorrow belongs to me. The babe in his cradle is closing his eyes. The blossom embraces the bee. But soon there's a whisper of eyes. Belongs to me. Oh, fatherland, fatherland, show us a sign. Your children waited to see. The morning will come when the world is mine. Tomorrow belongs, tomorrow belongs. The morning will come when the world is mine. Tomorrow belongs, tomorrow belongs, tomorrow belongs to me. Tomorrow belongs, tomorrow belongs, tomorrow belongs to me.
You still think you can control them?
Oh, my.